Welcome back to the Michael Imhotep Show on the Empowerment Radio Network, where knowledge is power. Right before the break, we were speaking with Dr. Cornell William Brooks, NAACP President and CEO. He is in Missouri, and they are on their seven-day march journey for justice, Ferguson to Jefferson City, going all the way up to the nation's capital, a 120-mile journey. Do we have Dr. Brooks back on the line?
I am indeed, right here.
Okay, brother. All right, sorry about
Thank you, man.
You know how it is, brother. We got to pay the bill, so we had to go to commercial. Well, you know, before we brought you on, before we brought you and Brother Ali on, I played the clip from this weekend, MSNBC, the interview Alex Witt did with you. And you all have been getting a lot of coverage. I posted the flyer on our Facebook fan page, the African History Network. It got about 1,000 likes. March to the Capitol, Missouri, Justice for Michael Brown, and also posted the article TheRoot.com did.
Thank you.
No problem. And one of the things that I liked about this is that you laid out some clear-cut goals that you all are fighting for. Just reiterate a few of those for us, if you don't mind.
Absolutely. So this march is really predicated on a deep moral grounding, but we're seeking specific policy reforms. For example, passing a Mike Brown law to put cameras on the uniforms and bodies of police officers. Mm-hmm. At the federal level, passing the Anti-Racial Profiling Act so that we can keep our young people from being profiled and stigmatized and subjected to discrimination and racial profiling. We're also seeking civilian review panels so that police departments are held accountable. We're also seeking very specifically a change in the strategy, the tactic, and the philosophy of policing. That is to say, very specifically, we are encouraging police departments to model the most effective police departments. That is to say, police departments that engage and enlist communities in their work. So in other words, where communities are involved in policing and are trusted by the police and the police trust them, not only are the communities made safer, police officers are in fact safer, prosecutions are easier, and policing is both more efficient and more effective. So the point being here is we know the best practices. We know the reforms that need to be done. But we simply have to create the will to do that which we already know to do. The path of legislation has already been drafted and that is ready to be passed. So this march, which is so we know it. We can do this. This march of 7 days, 120 miles across the length and breadth of Missouri and into the hearts and conscience of Americans everywhere, really is predicated on the Selma to Montgomery March. That march was half the length of this march. That march began with a small group of people, ended with thousands. That march began with the death of Jimmie Lee Jackson almost 50 years ago. This march begins with the death and in honor of the memory of Michael Brown. So we are literally tapping into our history, tapping into our legacy, and we have a moral self-confidence that because of the righteousness of our cause, the breadth of support, and our tremendous capacity as a nation, as a people, that we're going to get this done. It may not be easy, but we will undoubtedly get it done.
Right. Let me just hit on a couple of things. I'm going to let you go because I know you're very busy, and we appreciate you taking time out of your busy schedule to talk to us today. Now, you said that the legislation has already been drafted. Did I hear you correctly when you said that?
Yes. So at the federal level, the Anti-Racial Profiling Act has already been drafted.
Okay.
That we have.
Mm-hmm. And then what is needed for that to actually become law?
We simply have to convince our legislators in Congress to pass the law. Because here's what we know. Mm-hmm. Ferguson is not an isolated town, and Michael Brown was not an isolated incident of police brutality. This is something which is a challenge for the whole of the country. And we need legislative reform. And the way to bring that about is to simply convince Americans and convince the citizens of Missouri to do that which we know to do. Okay. And we're simply bringing it together.
All right, and this is going to be this proposed legislation is national though, right? It's not just for Missouri, but it's national. Is that correct?
Indeed, it is both national, state, and at the municipal level.
At the municipal level. Okay, so we know that there's been gridlock in Congress, in the House of Representatives, and in the Senate, and we hear about that, and we know that this when the Senate comes when they resume in January, you're going to have a change in the Senate. The Republicans will be in control of the Senate. What do you need from us? What do you, because for people to support this, they don't have to be members of the NAACP. They may not be on the march. They may even disagree with some things the NAACP does, but these are things that we can all galvanize our efforts around. So what do you need us, the listeners, to do and the masses of African Americans? What do you need us to do?
Here's what we need to do. It's not about being a member of the NAACP or the Urban League.
Right.
It's not about which group you're in. Mm-hmm. It's about our shared humanity and our shared citizenship. That's what this is about. And so here's what you can do. What you can do is call upon your legislator to support anti-racial profiling legislation. You can call upon your governor to sign this in terms of reform of policing. You can also call upon your mayors, city councilmen, to take a stand here. It's just that simple.
Okay. All right. Now, can we go to any website and see all this, like the goals and everything? Is there anywhere where we could go and see all this succinctly delineated so we can share this with other people as well to galvanize an effort to bring this into fruition?
Thank you, Gordon. I'm sorry, I didn't hear the question.
Is there anywhere we can go, like a website or something like that, where we can go to where it lays out, you know, the goals of the march and what needs to be done and things like this, so we can share this with other people and galvanize efforts around this?
Certainly. If you go to the NAACP website, www.naacp.org, you'll find specific legislation, you'll find talking points, you'll find information on the march. And so we have specific legislation that people can get behind, and it's all there on the website.
Wow. Now so go ahead.
Well, we just thank everyone for their support.
Yes.
And we look forward to seeing you on the march. Certainly, march where you are and log the miles on our website, or pray for us. And certainly we welcome any support that we can get in terms of getting out the message, feeding the marchers, or convincing our country that we can do better.
Right, and can people? I know people can donate. Can people donate at the NAACP website, or do they donate at Reverend Witherspoon's church? If people want to donate a case of water or some money to buy food, what should they do?
They go to the NAACP website. That's ideal.
Okay, NAACP.org. Okay, excellent. Well, look, brother, I know you're busy. We appreciate it. You stay safe down there, and we'll get you back on again soon, okay?
Okay, thank you. God bless.
All right, let me speak to Brother Ali again if you can. Thank you. All right, that was Dr. Cornell William Brooks, president of the NAACP and CEO of the NAACP, talking about the journey for justice, Ferguson to Jefferson City, and he laid out very succinctly and concretely what the goals are. Hold on, Ali. What the goals are of this march is not to gain exercise, is to bring about legislation, and the legislation has already been proposed. visit their website, NAACP.org, and you can read what the goals are of this in the legislation. Okay, Brother Ali, just hold the line.
Yes, sir.
Hold the line. We're coming up on a break. We're going. I'm gonna bring you back over, and we'll wrap this up on the other side of the break. Okay. Can you just hold the line for
a minute? Everybody.
Can you hold the line for a minute? We're going to break. Just hold the line. Okay.
Gotcha.
All right. Thanks. Listen to the Michael Imhotep Show on the Empowerment Radio Network, where knowledge is power. We'll be back in a few minutes. If you're just tuning in our first hour, we talked to Dr. Cornell William Brooks, who is the president and CEO of the NAACP, and we talked about their 7-day, 120-mile march that started November 29th in Ferguson, Missouri, and it concludes December 5th in Jefferson City, the state capital. It's called Journey for Justice, Ferguson to Jefferson City, and he laid out very succinctly, very concisely, what the goals are of this march. This is not to get exercise, okay? This is to bring about policy change, new laws, and legislation has already been proposed. Legislation is already drafted, okay? They want body cameras on police officers across the country. They want the End to Racial Profiling Act passed as law. They want new leadership in the Ferguson Police Department, beginning with the police chief, and for reforms of police practice and culture in Ferguson and across the country. There's a number of different things that he laid out for us. Keep in mind, this show repeats Monday through Friday, 10 p.m. to 1 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 10 p.m. to 1 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. This show repeats right here on the Empowerment Radio Network. Okay, and to listen to the show, download that TuneIn Radio app to your Android phone, your iPhone, your BlackBerry, your tablet, and search for Empowerment Radio Network, or go to TuneIn.com and search for Empowerment Radio Network. You can also visit our website, AfricanHistoryNetwork.com, AfricanHistoryNetwork.com. We have the information for the Michael Imhotep Show right there with the link, all the information. So you can check that out as well, okay? Now, on the line, we still have Brother Ali, so I want to go back to Brother Ali. All right, Brother Ali, so are you with them? Are you going to be with them for all 7 days of the march?
Yes, sir. I'm here for the duration. So
okay,
22 and a half miles, 22 miles a day, ain't no joke, Doc.
Now, you're doing 22 miles a day, you said?
That's what we're doing. Yes,
okay.
Sir.
All right, excellent, man. Now, when you called me earlier, you said that also you all, people driving by, have said some negative things as well. Is that correct? Is that correct?
Yes, sir. Got a few people to blow. Some people blow for support. Say, hey, right on. But when we got into a different county yesterday, where it got popular.
Wow.
And a bunch of
profanity. Wow, interesting. So and
yes,
it's amazing why somebody would feel like they have to do that, why they would have to, you know, yell obscenities and racial epithets and things like this to dehumanize people. You know, that's
this reminds me of Forsyth County and it's mostly Europeans in this area. It's not okay. Many African faces. It's not a friendly area. And the farther we go closer to the mansion, the more rural and the more racial insensitivity we're going to experience. So the police told us to be careful yesterday. The police said we need to be careful.
Man, well, it sounds like you need the Deacons for Defense and Justice down there to protect you all, man.
We got one police officer walking with. We got a retired police officer with us. I don't know if you want to holler at him, but he's
good.
He quit because he said it was too corrupt.
Okay. All right, man. We got to get out of here. But thanks for reporting for us, man. On behalf of the Empowerment Radio Network, and you keep us posted on what's going on down there. You all be safe as well. Okay.
Yeah. What does Spoon want to say? Holler at him. What's Spoon? Just holler at him.
Okay.
Yeah. What does Spoon just say?
Oh, Witherspoon. Yeah.
Good morning, Brother Hotel.
Hey.
Yeah, how you doing, Brother
Hotel? How you doing? You all right?
Doing all right this morning. Hope you are.
Oh, excellent. Well, you know, we had Dr. Dr. Cornell William Brooks on, and definitely appreciate what you all are doing. And he laid out the goals of this and the legislation that needs to be passed and the legislation that has been drafted. Also, I emailed you information from Dr. Ray Hagans on changing information changing Missouri State Statute 563.046, dealing with Missouri's law on the use of force among law enforcement.
Yeah.
So check that out when you get a chance also, brother.
Great.
Look, man,
I'll check it out today.
Okay, no problem. So how things been going so far for you all down there?
Well, things are going well. We've gotten support from the church, the staff there, and they've been very hospitable and taking care of the physical needs of the people and make sure they have nutrition. And then even from the community, we're getting persons from different faith groups who are joining us. Some join different groups every day. And so then the teach-ins have been great in the evenings. We have solidarity. And we have to give a shout-out to several of the young people who came from various colleges and universities to participate and help us with this as well. So the momentum is building, and the enthusiasm is up, and the morale is very, very high. Looking forward to getting to Jefferson City.
Wow, wow. Now, very quickly, what are some of the things that you all cover in the evening at the teach-ins?
I talked about the significance of nonviolent protests, how to do that, how to mobilize, how to organize, and strategize so that there are significant outcomes from the protest. We talked about making sure that as a family that we come together so that there's one message, one band, one sound. And talked about the significance of the African-American church needing to take the forefront again and helping to shape our communities and working with other religious organizations and even some organizations that are 501c3s to help reshape our communities, especially in the black community, to be for positive change.
Wow. Okay. Excellent. Well, look, brother, I know you got to run, but we appreciate it, and we'll talk to you again soon, okay?
Looking forward to talking to you again, too. Have a wonderful day.
Okay, thanks. You too, brother. Thanks. All right. That's Reverend Witherspoon. Okay, Brother Ali, we appreciate the report, okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay, all right. Take care, brother. Be safe. All right, hotel.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Okay, that was Brother Ali, Reverend Witherspoon, and Dr. Cornell William Brooks reporting from us in Missouri. The seven-day journey for justice, Ferguson to Jefferson City. 120-mile journey, and they laid out also the goals of this, the proposed legislation, and what we need to do as well to bring this into fruition. All right. Okay, we're coming up on the break. On the other side of the break, I got to get into this clip here. You know, Melissa Harris Perry had an excellent segment this past weekend. Why can't we feel black men's pain? Why can't we feel black men's pain? Also, I have a clip from a presentation from Dr. Joy DeGruy. She wrote the book Post-Traumatic Slave Syndrome, and she deals with the dehumanization of African people throughout history to remove the cognitive dissonance. You relabel them. You put labels on them, saying that they're phlegmatic, saying that they're lazy, they're lustful, saying that they're demons. So then you can justify the way you mistreat them.